Which people have had the strongest impact on your life? Who has had the strongest impact on your life?
Live people, people now, not old-fashioned dead artists.
Could be any mixture, but yeah, let's start with the living and then let's start with the dead, and then finish with the dead, rather.
Sheila. My parents. In his time, Henry Moore. Kenneth Noland, Jules Zelitsky, Clement Greenberg, Michael Fried. Those are my contemporaries that have had the biggest, not my connect, but the ones who've been alive for me. Dead. Donatello. Picasso, Matisse, difficult. Masaccio, Bellini, Giotto, Rembrandt, yeah, I'm just running through in my head names like Rubens and El Greco and people, and they're not quite. They're just marvellous, but they're not quite.
What was the first work of art you remember seeing and noticing and being intrigued by when you
were... Oh, Stanley Spencer. you know, the steelworkers and the Clyde and that sort of thing. And the other day, I found myself at Cookham, and I went into the museum. He wasn't half bad. He doesn't travel. He's provincial, but he's not bad. Oddly enough, I don't know why he's less good than Rousseau, because Rousseau isn't provincial, and Stanley Spencer is, and they're both very alike in some ways. What's your answer to that?
I think Rousseau is more of a mystery. I think Spencer is clearer. I think we're drawn to Rousseau because of the mystery. We can't work out with Rousseau whether he knows how naive he's being, whether it's an accident, or whether he's actually an incredibly sophisticated man who's hiding behind something.
I really like that mystery, that idea of the word mystery, because you don't want such literalness. And the English are inclined to be over literal in their paintings. I mean, you know, you see that when you see Whistler as against Monet and so on. You see it when you see this show of
Sickert,
Degas, yeah. You know? And you see it, or you see even somebody not an Englishman. Tissot, there's no mystery there. It's all there. And Caillebotte, it's too much there. I want something I'm not sure about, you know? Which is, I know, in a way, partly why Manet is such a treasure. Or Monet's Nymphaeus, you know?
Where did you see the Spencer when you were young, by the way? Was that in a book, or you saw it in
No,
a
I think it was at the National Gallery when there was all the work was taken away to Wales and hidden, and he had done these wartime paintings of people painting people making ships in the Clyde. That's what I remember.
So you were brought up during the war by your parents to London and saw this happening in the National Gallery?
Yes, maybe it was after that, and maybe it was when I was in the Navy by that time, but it was, I don't remember which year it was. But, it was shown there, and it had a big impression, a big influence on me. And at that time, I was very, people like Christopher Wood were big not influence so much, but they were the artists that I was feeling were the interesting ones, new ones.
Who was the first professional or proper, in inverted commas, artist you ever met?
Well, I met Charles Wheeler because he was a friend of the housemaster, my housemaster at school.
So what, you were a teenager then?
Yeah. And I met him, and I, for a little while, I think when I was about 18, before I went in the Navy, I worked in Wheeler's studio and worked and learned a bit working with his assistant, who was called Chadwick. And not Lynn Chadwick, but his name was Chadwick. And I learned a lot from him, you know. I learned a little bit from him. Being in a studio was very exciting.
So was that the moment you suddenly thought, yeah, this is the life I want?
No, I think I'd pretty well decided by then, yeah.